the spinach that caused the outbreak was washed and bagged right here.
The reports seem frequent, the news frightening. For most of us, foodborne illness is seen as a threat, but scientists at the UC Davis Western Institute for Food Safety and Security see an opportunity to make a difference.
Our primary charge is to try to figure out what is going on that is leading up to these outbreaks. For example, how are produce fields getting contaminated?
These investigators use DNA fingerprinting to track deadly pathogens like E. coli or salmonella and to learn how they move from water or animal into our food supply. It's knowledge that could mean faster response times, quicker identification of the tainted source, and a safer global food supply.
My foodborne illness was mild compared to Regan's, but I never want to go through what I went through again.
For Tiffany Erickson's family, the research is life-saving. The Utah family was affected by the 2006 spinach outbreak traced back to a farm in California. Her four-year-old son, Regan, spent a month in the hospital and nearly died as a result. DNA fingerprinting matched his E. coli with hundreds more across the country and eventually with the actual food source.
It's probably the number one way, and right now in modern times, that large multi-state outbreaks are being identified.
For researchers at UC Davis, DNA fingerprinting is a tool that could provide valuable information about harmful pathogens and how they make their way into our homes.
I think it's important to find out, you know, the base of the problem. Where does E. coli come from?
In Davis, I'm Kristen Samos.